to God.
Yes.
That keeps us from being used by God. God says, I don't dwell in an unclean temple.
Right.
Amen. It may not be what y'all want to hear, but this is the Lord. Amen. Amen. We gotta remove all of the debris and all of the clutter. According to the original plans and the blueprint that God had, there's no place for such things. Amen. We gotta remove it out of the way. This requires, like I said, a daily check of ourselves. We gotta crucify this flesh daily. Amen. Ask God in to create in me a clean heart, oh God, and renew the right spirit within me. I don't care how much you walk around with your Bible up under your arm. I don't care how big the chain is with a cross that you have on. I don't care how big it is. Guess what? Every one of us, we still a work in progress. Every one of us, we got to do some things to clean out on the inside. Amen. We got to clear out the sight. We got to clear out the sight. Amen. God may not be, he's building a kingdom that's much bigger than what we can imagine. So if we're going to be a lively stone built up, we got to get rid of those things that hinder the process. Amen. Before that new structure could be built. Amen. They had to tear down the old building. They had to tear down the old building for each one of us as believers, as Christians, before we can be and become all that God has for us and want and desire for us to be. Amen. We got to tear out some stuff. Got to tear out some stuff. Amen. So they had to clear out the site. And then a few days later, as I was going down the road, I went down just to check on the progress, and I noticed that all of the debris and all of the clutter had been removed. Amen. And the ground has started to look a little bit different. Why? Because they had begun to prepare the site. Amen. That's what we have to do. Once we have removed all of the debris, all of the clutter, all of the mess, then we got to begin to prepare the site. They begin to break up the fallow ground. Amen. And anytime you're getting ready to build something, you have to begin to break up the ground. You got to disturb that which has been untouched. Amen. You got to reach into some places that we don't think nobody else knows anything about. But look now, if man knows about it, but God knows about it. And we're going to be the person that he's going to use for his glory. Amen. We got to let him break up the fallow ground. Amen. I told someone a few weeks ago, I said, we get upset when God shows us ourselves, but we really ought to be glad when God shows us who we really are. Why is that? Because when he shows us who we really are, then we can get that thing right and we can fix it, amen, so that we know that we're walking in the will and the purpose of God. They begin to prepare the site, so some dirt work had to be done. The foundation couldn't be laid until the dirt work had been done. Oh my God. And what are you saying right there? I'm saying that change is necessary. Transformed by the renewing of your mind. How can I make sure that I got the right foundation? salvation. Amen. I gotta make sure Jesus is my chief cornerstone. I gotta make sure that I have Jesus within my heart. Amen. I'm not just talking about you said, I'm saved. I'm talking about you made him Lord and Savior of your life. Yeah, because see, when you make him Lord of your life, that says that you give him complete control. You give him complete control. So how do I know that I have the right foundation? I make Jesus my chief cornerstone. I spend some time in the Word. I'm not talking about what you just said, I read a scripture, but I'm talking about you spend some time meditating on it day and night. The Word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against God. I'm talking about spending some time in the Word of God where I can get understanding of what it is that God is trying to say. Seeking the sincere milk of understanding through the Word of God so that I can grow. Amen. And as we begin to study and mature in the Word of God, it continues to build us up and, amen, causes us to begin to operate in our full potential. Amen. Then we won't be tossed to and fro. By everything that blows through. You know, some of us grab hold to everything that flies. Amen. The next apostle come to town, there we go. Everybody want to be an apostle. I don't think God called the whole world to be an apostle. And don't get me wrong, but I believe in the fivefold ministry. Amen. But everybody can't be an apostle. And everybody can't be a prophet. But we won't be tossed to and fro. Amen. We won't be operating and doing stuff that we know is contrary to the Word of God because we know what the Word of God says. Amen. Amen. Every structure built must have a strong, solid foundation in order to stand. And you know what? As I observed what they were doing with that building, what I observed is that the foundation was probably the most difficult part of putting that building together. But guess what? It's the least visible, but it's the most important. It's the least visible, but it's the most important. Oh my God. See, some of us worried about if somebody can see what we're doing. That's not what's important. What's important is what's down in here, that foundation that we have. If the foundation isn't right, then guess what? The floors will begin to crack. The walls will begin to lean. Oh yeah. Even the ceiling, the roof might begin to start to fall down. Amen. Come crashing down. That's the same way it is for us as believers. Everything rests on our foundation. And if we're not grounded in the Word of God, diligent in our fasting and in our praying, amen. Amen. And having a prayer life with him and having faith in Jesus Christ. Amen. Guess what? The least little storm that comes through, we crash. And you know, Pastor Watson, I know y'all didn't do that over here. Amen. But, you know, sometimes people take shortcuts and use poor quality material. And that has a tendency to cause problems down the road. Might seem all right or might seem good at the time, but in the long run, can you imagine building a building with some crook struts, some studs, or some warped plywood? Come on. It wouldn't take very long before that thing comes crashing down under the first sign of pressure, right? So we can't try to be built up spiritually with cheap material. We can't be running and falling at the fluff of what we hear being preached over the pulpit. Yeah. Just because somebody got a good holler. Yeah. Oh my God. Just because they got a good squall. We can't be messed up by that. We can't just think that we got it together because we get the Word on Wednesday and on Sunday. Amen. We can't survive on a diet of just gravy and desserts. Because you know what? You'll end up with nothing but diarrhea. The Bible talks about it. The other one built his house on sand. But when the storm came, the one that was built on sand began to crumble and fall down. Oh my God. I know y'all don't have that over here. I'm gonna go back on the other side of town. That's why that every time somebody's going through and every time they got a problem, amen, they look like whooped down, beaten and defeated little Christians, amen, because they built on the wrong foundation, amen. See, guess what? What we'll do is we're going to tell them something about sin.
Yeah. All right.
Ain't nothing good coming out there. No. Nothing good coming out. That's why some folks' lives are jacked up right now. Right. Because they've been going and listening to somebody that don't have no foundation in the Word of God, that don't spend no time in prayer, that don't spend no time, amen, fasting and praying, amen. And then they're going and telling somebody what thus said the Lord. Well, the Lord didn't tell them that, amen. They tell them that out of themselves. The scripture says, of the ungodly, amen. Oh my God. You better start walking around letting everybody tell you everything and spend some time on your face before God for yourself. The more time we spend with Him, amen, the stronger the foundation becomes and the more built up we become. The answer to everything that we need is found in the Word of God. The more we digest it, the more we understand the purpose and the plan that God designed for each one of us. Once the foundation's been set, amen, when we're on that solid foundation, when we have Jesus as the chief cornerstone, and we got the Word down on the inside of our hearts, amen, and we're spending time in prayer, and we're fasting with God, then we begin to erect the building. Walking in that purpose for which God created us, for which He called us. What is that? To serve Him. When the building on Arkansas Boulevard, amen, was going up, its original purpose was for it to become a farmer's bank. And just like with each one of us, amen, God's original purpose for each one of us was for us to be His mouthpiece, to be His kingdom representative. Amen. We were to display His beauty so that those that are lost in a dying and sinful world, and y'all do know that we're in a dying and sinful world, amen. When we look out there and you find people that says anything goes, we're in a dying and a sinful world, amen. Amen. We were to be His representatives, and if we're His representatives, then we are to give glory to the building. When you walk, when you get on Interstate 30 and you head to Dallas, before you get to Dallas, you know you're in Dallas because of the beautiful buildings that's there. And I know that the architects are very proud of that. Every time they read on the internet or they see what people have made comments about the beautiful structure that's there. That's the way we ought to be as it relates to the body of Christ. That we ought to be able to give God that same glory that when somebody looks at us, they say, what is it that you're doing that I need to do that I can give God the same glory? Who is this God that you serve, that He makes you look like that, that He makes you look like royalty, that He makes you look like, amen, that you are the queen of queens? Oh my God. To be this place to give Him glory. And can I just help somebody? One stone don't make a building. One stone don't make a wall. It takes a whole lot of to make the thing come together. What are you trying to say? I'm trying to say Tower of Power. It's not about one man. It's not about two, because two can't make a building either. Amen. But it takes a whole to make up the whole building. Amen. To embrace that beautiful manifestation. So when you leave from here and you go out and people say, oh my God, I can just see you glowing. I can just see the light.